So the hotter weather is finally upon us, and now is the time to start wearing these bright, citrusy, aquatic, fresh fragrances. And I waited specifically for this time to review Salado by Carner Barcelona. I'm very excited to give you my thoughts on this fragrance, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin today's episode and I give you my thoughts on Salado by Carner Barcelona, this is an aquatic fragrance. It's salty, it's spicy, it's a little fresh, so on and so forth. I do want to start the video off first by saying that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, please do consider supporting the channel by subscribing to it. Hit the bell icon, click where it says enable all notifications, and give this video a thumbs up. If you took something of value from today's episode, it would really mean a lot to me. Now, I have a lot of Carner Barcelona fragrances, El Born, Rose and Dragon, Queers is another one. So this is a brand that has a bunch of quality when it comes to their fragrances, very high quality. Their fragrances tend to last a very long time. Even something like D600, which is an iris-based fragrance, gives you really, really good longevity to the point where I was very surprised by how long-lasting their fragrances are. Here we have one called Salado, and this fragrance is exactly what I was expecting. I looked at the note breakdown, I thought to myself, with pink pepper and cucumber and petitgrain and all these clean, fresh, citrusy, spicy ingredients, I think this is gonna be a summer fragrance with a bit of an edge. And I was exactly right. As a matter of fact, if you take a look at the note breakdown, it's actually right on the back here. It says, top, pink peppercorn, Paraguayan petitgrain, Italian bergamot. In the mid, you have Moroccan orange blossom, cucumber, and Japanese privé tree flower. In the base, you have salt accord, wood floated accord, and musk. So as you can see, this is definitely an aquatic, salty, fresh, spicy, slightly vegetal sort of a scent. In any case, I'm excited to give you my thoughts on the smell. Let's start things off with a quick look at the presentation. Now, right in the opening of this fragrance, you are going to get the petitgrain and the bergamot. Of course, these are citrus notes, right? So they're a bit more on the volatile side of things. Yes, petitgrain is a little woodsy as well. It's citrusy and woodsy. It's usually referred to as the poor man's neroli, but I love petitgrain because it does have the citrusy components, but it has the woody undertone as well. So it kind of creates a more grounding experience. And I think it also adds to the longevity of the fragrance as well. So basically it opens up very bright with the bergamot and the petitgrain. It's really fresh. And then very quickly, you will get that combination of salt and cucumber. It's really interesting because the salt that's in here, it does give you these aquatic vibes and aquatic tendencies. And it's like, wow, this is quite marine and oceanic without it smelling like seaweed or algae or anything like that. And there are fragrances out there like Healy Selmaran that really do smell like seaweed, algae, and some people find them to be a big turnoff. For me personally, this fragrance is actually really nice, right? The cucumber in here is very fresh and refreshing. You might equate it to the smell of fragrances like Polo Blue by Ralph Lauren. I think it's closer to Roses on Ice by Kilian Paris. So even with Roses on Ice, right, you kind of have like the rose, the cucumber. Here we have Pink Pepper, which has a little bit of a rosy vibe. And so that combination of those two ingredients could kind of create a similar experience. But for me, this fragrance reminded me more of Ege by Nishane, and there's also Atlantis by Blue Atlas. So if you can think about those two fragrances, how they're very like bright and earthy and maybe a little vegetal and aromatic, but also very citrusy with a bit of that clean, smooth, aquatic undertone, that's exactly what you're gonna get here. In terms of the musk that's found in the base, I think if anything, it pairs up with the orange blossom and the peppercorn and some of these other brighter, more volatile ingredients to kind of establish like a clean base. And then, like I said, the wood floated accord. There isn't anything about this fragrance, to my nose at least, that is explicitly woodsy. And I would say that because a lot of these other ingredients tend to overshadow it, like the brighter, more citrusy ingredients, which are really kind of the heart of this fragrance. Not literally in terms of the note pyramid, but in terms of the vibe and the ambiance that it gives across. This is a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful fragrance for the spring and summer. So if you're looking for a unique olfactive experience, You don't want to smell run-of-the-mill. You want to smell different. You want something that puts you in the mindset of like being on a tropical oasis. Check out Salado by Carner Barcelona. I truly find that this fragrance is wonderful. Definitely aligned with my personal taste. When it comes time for me to do my summer list, you better believe that I'm going to be featuring this fragrance in that video. Can't wait to wear this fragrance more. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. Now, first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, for me, this fragrance is certainly unique. I think if you're a fan of fragrances like Ege by Nishane, Blue Atlas's Atlantis, or even Roses on Ice by Kilian Paris, definitely check out Salado by Carner Barcelona. But again, it does its own thing, right? It does have that sort of Japanese floral presence. It has the salt accord. It has the citrus. It has a lot of really wonderful elements to it. In terms of the longevity, you can expect about 8 hours on your skin. In terms of the projection, it was really good for the first 45 minutes of application. It radiated beyond an arm's length. It became an elbow's length scent right around hour 5. A skin scent right around hour 8. In terms of the versatility, perfectly unisex, great for the hotter weather, great for casual or formal scenarios, and anybody of any age would properly enjoy this fragrance. And then, of course, in terms of the presentation, I think the presentation for Carner Barcelona fragrances is very nice. The wooden cap, the heavy bottle, it sits very comfortably into place in the presentation, and the distribution on the atomizer is very good as well. My final verdict on this fragrance is, if you are looking for a unique summer fragrance, something that is not too much of a novelty scent in terms of the salt accord or all these other notes, but something that gives you a refreshing experience, allows you to smell unique and different, while also alluding to some really wonderful niche fragrances, definitely check out Salado by Carner Barcelona. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you took something of value from today's review. If you did, please do consider supporting the channel by subscribing to it. Hit the bell icon so you can be notified whenever I do upload future videos to the channel. And of course, give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Thanks again for watching. Love you guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.